Hello and welcome. In our efforts to introduce you to the latest of technologies, today we have with us Mr. Sridhar Dharmarajan, Managing Director of the Indo-Pacific region for MSC Software. So Mr. Dharmarajan, what I understand about simulation, the engineers and the students that will fuel tomorrow's workforce have already started using simulation to make design decisions. So what more has given simulation industry its momentum?
So any part that you design has a form and a function. So we take care of the functional aspect of the part. Essentially we simulate how does the part perform in realistic environment. So today with the advancement in hardware, we can accurately predict to the 10th decimal if the deflection of a car when it actually goes and hits a wall, goes and hits a footpath, what is the deflection of the front bonnet, to what level, up to the 10th decimal point we can actually simulate, and that will be the realistic behavior as well. So in the last 55 years of our existence, ever since we started, we have come a long way in accurately predicting the different physics, multi-physics and the realistic behavior in the simulation environment. That's one of the reasons, if you really see our tagline, is that we simulate reality and deliver certainty. So we're able to simulate the realistic behavior and deliver exactly how the situation happens in a realistic environment. So with this, people are able to take confidence in the simulation area, and they have the ability to go ahead and use that knowledge to try out multiple variants in their design process and arrive at the design without spending so much on the physical prototypes. As an organization, we always have a goal that we need to eliminate the physical test. The products are getting more and more complex. While we are going on eliminating some physical tests, there may be a few tests which will be required. And so this is a good vision to have, because we are kind of chasing the vision, getting the products faster, getting the products lighter, getting the products more durable, and these products are all much more efficient. If you really look at any product today in any industry, are much more efficient. Now, some of the challenge today is to how do we ensure that the students who are coming out of the engineering college are having this knowledge, so that they are actually industry ready, they are actually employable immediately. At the same time, industry has these resources. So we have gone ahead and started working with the various universities in the country, teaching them the simulation tools, teaching them the physics, teaching them the multi-physics, and today we are having a stream of people who are walking out of the engineering colleges who are employable ready to large organizations in the automotive industry, aerospace industry, machinery industry, heavy industry, shipping, the different industries. As I said earlier, any product design company will need a simulation software for you to do simulation, to predict how the product actually behaves in the real world and the real environment. Today we are taking simulation into the design world. Today we are, more and more simulation has to be used. You need the availability of the engineers to actually kind of have this knowledge to actually use it. At the same time, the engineers should ensure that they know how to use the tool as well, because at the end of the day, you put garbage in, you're going to get garbage out. So we have a very active university program where we teach our products. We tell the people, don't teach engineering, help the students to visualize engineering, use our products. So whether it's thermodynamics or strength of materials, we teach in the new MSC way, as we really kind of call it, so that they understand the whole process. So we are constantly working, ensuring that the students are trained and these engineers are all available to the industry. So that's always been my goal, where I can do the industry and academia connect, and we have a very active engagement with various universities in the country today.
Well, this is a promising vision and one that serves for the betterment of the industry at large. Speaking of the challenges, brief us on the kind of challenges that exist in the present simulation software market, and how is your R&D responding to these challenges?
See, the challenges faced is always the complex industry solutions requirement. So today, if you really look at the automotive space, if you really look at it, we are moving away from the IC engines to the electric world. That's a kind of trend which is really happening. So challenges are continuing in various industries and various products, and we need to ensure that we understand the physics and we actually come up with the upgraded versions of the software to address these new challenges. It could be in automotive, it could be aerospace, it could be. So we invest heavily in R&D every year. So we have about 9 to 10 R&D centers worldwide. India is one of the biggest R&D center. We have about 250 people there who are also working on creating cutting edge technologies for the industry, which is constantly evolving. So let's take even autonomous. Today, people are talking about autonomous cars, right? So earlier we used to actually only design the car. Today we have to design the driver as well, what decision he has to make based on the situations around. So when you're having a driverless car, you need to actually also go ahead and decide what decisions that you'll have to make, whether you have to turn left or turn right, reduce the speed, brake. So these things comes into play. So we can actually scan the entire environment. We are part of a bigger portfolio today with Hexagon group companies. So we can scan the external environment, and that can be the input to the car. And we can digitally simulate how the car should behave. If there is a school bus, and it has to identify a school bus, it has to identify an ambulance, it has to identify a policeman or a sudden pedestrian crossing across. We can simulate the performance of the car and generate huge amounts of data so that, you know, using our artificial intelligence engine, the car would be able to behave in a particular way even in those situations which has not been simulated earlier. So the way the products are getting used, the way the products are getting designed, fully functional driving car to a driverless car to an autonomous car. So these are the constant challenges that we face, and industry keeps throwing us these problems, and we create those solutions to those problems, and the customers are actually getting those solutions to simulate the performance of this new kind of products. So it could be again in any industry as such.
It's quite amazing to know how MSC has been overcoming such complex challenges across industry. In fact, 2018 witnessed quite a few bombshell in CAE and simulation. How did the acquisition of MSC by Hexagon change the overall technology offerings of your company?
So with the Hexagon acquisition, we have in the design and engineering space, MSC plays a role. In the manufacturing place, we have a sister company, Hexagon Production Software, which actually plays a role. In the measurement space, in the metrology space, we have Hexagon Metrology, or part of the Hexagon Manufacturing Intelligence, plays a role. So what we are trying to do is we are trying to create a digital thread between all these various technologies, so that as designed, as manufactured, as measured is one and the same. Because it's extremely important, the designer may actually create a great design, but if you have some manufacturing issues like the welding strength is not good or the forming strength is not good, there are some residual stresses while actually manufacturing the part. So the as manufactured part will not be same as the as designed part. So how do we ensure that the manufacturing issues are taken care ahead of the in the design space? And how do we ensure that if we can actually do the measurement also happening? Because Hexagon Metrology Division has got various measurement techniques. It could be a contact measurement, non-contact measurement, white light scanners. So you can continuously keep measuring as the manufacturing is happening. And again, we can apply some artificial intelligence there so that can the toolpath be changed for it to kind of take care of some of the information given by the measurement techniques so that you can get it right the first time. And even look at today new manufacturing techniques like additive manufacturing, where MSC is leading the world today. How do we simulate the additive manufacturing process that you can actually get it right the first time? So with this portfolio on the design side, on the manufacturing side, on the measurement side, we have the most comprehensive offering to the industry, where the industry can actually come to one single location and take care of the design issues, take care of the manufacturing issues, and ensure that the measurement is also synced in. So measurement is not really kind of a post manufactured scenario. Measurement can be included in the pre-manufactured scenario so that you can actually get it right the first time. It's very comprehensive offering. We are very excited with this whole Hexagon MSC relationship, Hexagon MSC being part of this whole Hexagon portfolio. The customers also see a lot of value that we can actually provide when we can integrate the design and engineering piece, manufacturing piece, and the measuring piece.
Clearly, the Hexagon and MSC collab has a lot in store for simulation industry, and I wish you all the best for that. Now, like you said, there has been numerous efforts to use modeling and simulation to improve manufacturing industry. So tell me, what is the progress like and how far have we come?
It's huge. Actually, simulation, Earlier, people used to use simulation as a step-brotherly treatment, where you design the part, and if the part fails in the field, you come to the simulation world and check why it failed. Today, you don't have time for that, because the product life cycle have got short, and the product, the time to develop the product is also getting shorter. So you need to ensure that you get the product faster into the market before your competition. You need to get the product right the first time. So those are the key things which are actually going to play in these various areas. So getting the product right the first time and ensuring that the time you take actually to develop the product is also fast. So these are the constant challenges where the product usage life cycle, people are using the product for a much shorter duration, and there is a constant pressure in getting it right the first time and ensuring that you actually kind of getting it faster into the market. For example, we have a product in our portfolio called Forming Technologies, because in any product life cycle, 80% of the cost is actually committed in the 20% of the product life cycle. So if you don't take care of the costing in the first 20%, if you want to make any changes later, it is too expensive. So we can simulate the total cost of the metal that is required in creating that particular part much earlier and optimize that activity. You have a huge saving. Simulation is exploding because new and new industry is adopting simulation, and they are actually using simulation more early in the product life cycle to get their product right, to get their product right the first time, to get their product faster into the market.
Simulation is exploding, like you said. On that note, tell our audience what's next in the simulation space.
It is, the future is very exciting. If you take the automotive, we spoke about autonomous cars. Did you ever imagine 10 years ago that we would potentially be going in a car which is completely driverless? In fact, we have seen some prototype where the front two seats face the back two seats. In certain cars, you have a complete, the bed which is actually there. So the driverless car is actually a huge, exciting opportunity for us. 2030 in Singapore is going to be completely driverless. And we are playing a key role in ensuring that all the simulations are done ahead of time. So automotive, there is a big revolution in the automotive space. One is the cars are becoming autonomous, and the cars are also getting into EV space. People are talking of hydrogen and various kind of combustion techniques, various kind of power usage. So automotive is actually going through a major revolution. Aerospace is going through a major revolution. Machinery was highly, was never really into CAE. They are under tremendous pressure to reduce the weight of their components. They are getting into simulation in a big way. Consumer electronics, phones, cameras, all these people are getting into simulation space. So simulation is actually pervading. It is becoming a horizontal function for all the industries. We are a 55-year-old company, and it's very pleasing to see where every day we have a new industry, a new company calling us and saying that, hey, we want this problem to be solved. We want to simulate this situation. And we are actually ready with the technology to actually do that. And MSC is poised, I would say we are at an inflection point to really take off in a big way because of the support that we're getting from the whole Hexagon family. And exciting times ahead, I would say, for the simulation area. And we have solutions for the various challenges that the industry actually is throwing us on a day-to-day basis.